Now, Storm Tracker 9 weather with Chief Meteorologist Justin Stapleton.
Welcome back, everyone, to South Eugene High Schools. We are here tonight for our game of the week. North Medford warming up behind us. You can see the Axemen behind me as well, also starting to get ready. Game time now in just about 38 minutes, and it has been a gorgeous afternoon on this Friday. Expect it to be a nice one, not only just here, but pretty much all across Western Oregon for those Friday night football games. Let's head out to the Storm Tracker 9 Live Radar Suite, but I'll show you what I mean by that. Now, we have seen a little bit of cumulus cloud cover kind of building up just back off to the south and east of us here, if we look back off towards that way. But most of that pretty much just kind of dissipated, and that's sort of what you're seeing out there right now. I've drawn the jet stream to show you what's been under the influence of what we've been under the influence of, what we'll call a big trough of low pressure, sort of where a jet stream dips down and we get some of that cool, unsettled weather. It's been moving through the region here for the better half of about 3 days now. Certainly not big rainmakers like we saw yesterday and some of the downpours yesterday afternoon, but you get the idea that we still have a little bit of an unsettled forecast. But it's nice out here right now in South Eugene. We're at 73 degrees on the field, 74 down at Roseburg. A little cooler as you get into the mountains and out to the coast. They're sitting at around 60 degrees. Newport, Florence, on down towards North Bend. So marine clouds will slide back in late night tonight, and they'll fill back into the valleys down to the Umpqua, and certainly here as you get across the Southern Valley. But as we move things in towards tomorrow afternoon, should see mostly sunny skies. And because we're still under the influence of a bit of a southerly flow just above the surface, that's going to give us a chance for a few thunderstorms to fire up. So overnight tonight, we'll dip down to the upper 40s to around 50 degrees. Cloudy start. Then we'll start to see more sunshine because of the little bubble of high pressure that builds in for not only your Saturday but Sunday forecast. Won't really last, though. By the time we get to Monday, we'll start to see some of the cooler weather and the wetter weather move back in as well for a couple of days. So we'll go morning clouds, sunny skies by the afternoon, or at least mostly sunny out at the coast with the temperatures in the low 60s. We'll go low to mid 70s down to the Umpqua after the clouds break up. Should be a beautiful sunny afternoon. Great looking early fall forecast for the Cascades as well. Lows to mid 60s, around 70 at Oak Ridge. But I am going to keep a mention of a few isolated pop-up thunderstorms by late afternoon. Might see one of those as well as you get into Central Oregon. Temperatures there will be in the mid 60s. And then finally for us here in the Willamette Valley, we'll go right around 70 to 72 degrees. Tad warmer as you get up towards Corvallis. Mostly sunny skies. As we mentioned, Corvallis Fall Festival, I think, should have a great rebound year from last year's rainout. So low to mid 60s for the next 6 to 7 days along the coast. That disturbance slides through Monday night into Tuesday. And then by Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, we'll start to see high pressure move back in. That one actually is going to be a little stronger. Thus, it'll probably extend, I think, through late next week and probably even into the weekend as well. So we'll go mid to upper 70s by Sunday's forecast, and then slight chance for some isolated showers coming through Tuesday. Then Thursday, Friday, look at that, temperatures back up close to 80 degrees. For the Cascades, slight chance for an afternoon pop-up thunderstorms through the weekend. Then as we get into Monday and Tuesday, not only will we cool off, there's a chance that some of the higher ski resorts, let's say Bachelor, for example, certainly Timberline and Meadows, might get a quick dusting and sort of a sloppy inch of snow. Here in the Willamette Valley, we'll go 72 tomorrow, 75 on Sunday, and then a bit cooler as we get that disturbance bringing some scattered showers in Monday night into Tuesday, and then Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. Brian, looking good as we go into next week as well, but right now it is absolutely beautiful out here. Hopefully, South Eugene can pull the upset tonight. Might be a little difficult, but you know what? They're going to do their darndest, and at least the weather's cooperating for a great night of Friday football.
I was going to say, doing their darndest, but they've got a great night for it. Thank you, Justin.